Hello, everybody. Hello, my beautiful besties. Welcome back to my channel. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. I already have my eyebrows done, which is not normal because this is a video of not doing other makeup. We're just doing my face makeup because, as you guys can see, I don't know what the fuck happened. I don't know what happened to my skin. My skin was doing amazing. I was on Accutane for about 6 months, and then my skin completely cleared. When you're on Accutane, you have to go to the doctor every month to get your prescription filled, because you have to get a blood test. And then when coronavirus started happening, I was scared to go to the doctors, because I wanted to stay in my house. So then I stopped taking Accutane, and I was like, it's fine, my skin's clear. And then recently, the last like 2 months, my cystic acne has been coming back. It's been making me kind of sad, but you know what? I'm not gonna let it defeat me. If you have acne, that's okay. You're still beautiful. Don't let it make you feel insecure, because I know that it can, because I know how you feel. But trust me, you're still a bad bitch. But I'm going to teach you guys in this video how I have learned techniques to cover my acne with makeup. I've made a video like this before, but I realized that the foundation that I was using in that video was actually causing me to break out more. So that was not okay. But this one, I've come to realize that the products that I'm using actually don't break me out. It's just my skin being my skin. Honestly, I'm having a good skin day. It's been worse. It's been worse. But yeah, that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna show you guys how to do how to cover your pimples with makeup. And make it a lot less noticeable, so maybe you could, I don't know, if you're insecure about it like I am, know that I'm with you on it, baby. But before we get into that, let's get into the sponsor of today's video. I'll see you guys in 1 second, even though you'll see me right there, but I'll see you guys in this time in a second. See you later. The sponsor of today's video is Felix Gray. Look how cute I look in these glasses. That's not the point though. They protect you from the blue light in all your devices. Did you know that that can affect your sleep? It can affect many things. And they have lots of different options on their website. Lots of different options. You can also, if you know your prescription, if you do wear glasses, they also have glasses on their website where you could put your prescription in, and you can also get the frames on there and get the style that you like, which is convenient too. But to protect you from the blue lights that you see on your phone daily, I'm working on my computer all the time, as I am right now editing my video for you guys. Or I'm watching TikTok, so I'm just on Twitter scrolling. You don't even realize that you're damaging your eyes. It can help you sleep better at night if you protect your eyes. Felix Gray lenses, they offer 15 times the protection of blue light against your phone and all your devices, which is a lot. That helps a lot. More than you would think. You guys are straining your eyes more than you know by using your devices every single day because of the blue light. And you guys can go and protect your little eyes, your little ojos. But you have a 30-day money-back guarantee. So that's it. Go ahead. Go ahead and click the link in my description. Alright? Thank you, Felix Gray. Oh my freaking goodness, I almost forgot to tell you which style I have. I am wearing Franklin in the style. It's hard to say. Oh my god, it's hard to say. I'm wearing Franklin in the style Sazerac Crystal. Beautiful. I like them because they have a red tint and they match my hair and they protect my eyes. Go to the link in my description. Okay, back to scheduled programming. I don't know how I like my eyebrows. I literally have been doing the feather brow effect and I've been tinting my eyebrows. I just tinted them, so they're like really dark right now. They need to like fade away a little bit. Let me know if you guys like my eyebrows, and if you do, I can make a video on how I tint them at home and how I do this feather brow. And let me know if you guys like my normal eyebrows better or my these eyebrows better. But let me get in the fucking video. I just ramble and ramble and ramble and I can't help it. I don't know why. I don't know. I just like to ramble. Might also be this. So, starting off, when you get you a good primer. Everybody's skin's different. Me personally, I have acne prone skin, obviously, sensitive skin, but my skin type is like normal. It's like both. It's like oily and dry. It's like, what is it? It's combination, that's the word. I have combination skin. So pretty much like I can like use any products on my skin, like whether it's dewy or matte, and my skin like goes with it. But yeah, I prefer having like a matte face because it keeps my makeup on longer. Also, remember, wash your face before you put makeup on it, moisturize it, and prime it. You want to put a barrier over your face before you go ahead and put makeup on it, because your skin will think that it's product, okay? If you don't put a barrier between your foundations and stuff, it's gonna think that it's like, and you leave it on all day, like it's gonna seep into your pores and it's gonna give you acne. And you need to make sure that you really take it off at the end of the day. You need to use toners, you need to use fucking makeup wipes, you need to cleanse your face, you need to do all that, okay? At the end of the day, remember to do that. Before we get started, let me just say that PSA, okay? Remember that. But you need to make a barrier. Me personally, I like to use a hydrating primer. This is Cool as a Cucumber from Ofra, and I just rub it on my face. My hands are clean. That's also a big thing. Make sure your hands are clean when you're rubbing up all over your face. I like to use two primers because I like to get rid of like my pores, because I have pretty big pores. This is the Dr. Brandt Pores No More. I used to use this a long time ago and I forgot about how freaking good it was, and I recently just bought it again. I like to do pore filling primers just because it's like, if I'm already gonna have my bumps showing from my acne, I like to at least have my pores looking nice and smooth. You get where I'm going with this? Okay, so another thing that I learned that was wrong, I used to take a concealer like this that you would like take out and put back in, right? And I would cover my acne first with this, and then I would go and use it and use it and use it. And like, I realized how much bacteria and acne and whatever I'm putting into this. So it's like, I needed to stop doing that. So I had an alternative and it started working for me better. So this is a very cheap little foundation stick. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation stick. And instead of using concealer to cover my acne prior to like putting my foundation on, because I don't believe in color correctors. I feel like it's easier to cover up like a skin tone color than like a green color. I don't know if that's just me. Hands are clean, right? Make sure after every use of this, you make it nice and clean, right? Okay? This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus. And you guys are gonna be like, wow, Corey, you use so much fucking product on your skin. But it's like, how do you expect me to cover my cystic acne and my scarring? I found that this is a better way to cover up my pimples prior to putting on my foundation, because just using it like a concealer like I was before, I was just dipping back into it, and it was literally just probably causing me to get more breakouts because I was putting, you get what I'm saying. And this, after every use, I can just clean it off. You know what I mean? Okay, yeah. And then now I go on with a beauty blender. This is a bad example right now. My beauty blender is actually very dirty. Clean your beauty blender and buy new ones regularly. Not a beauty blender. Get Real Techniques sponges, because these are much more affordable. $20 for a fucking sponge beauty blender? You're out of your fucking mind. Honestly, it's like a pre-foundation, to be honest. And if you really take your time blending and blending and blending and blending with your beauty blender, it doesn't look cakey. Like, if you're really pressing it into your skin, trust me, and you set it properly, like, trust me. Trust me, bitch. Okay, see? Look at where we're at now. Slightly covered. Didn't cover it completely, obviously, but that's where the foundation comes into play, all right? Okay, today we're gonna be using the Absolute Cover Foundation from Ofra. This is in the shade number 1. Honestly, a fucking dupe for this, I truly believe, the Maybelline Superstay, way cheaper, obviously, but this, I feel like, is the exact same as this, but I feel like, this one's more of my shade right now, so I'm gonna go in with this one. But these, like, honestly, they have the same coverage and, like, the same consistency, and, yeah, it's actually a really good match for me right now. Nice! If you guys know me, you know that's not normal. I feel like blending a lot, like, really, 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 really helps you not look cakey. I'm telling you, like, if you really, really sit here and blend your face for a really long time, you won't look cakey. I swear, like, the things that take me the longest with my makeup is definitely, like, my whole face. Like, my base and everything. Like, my whole face, that it takes me for sure the longest. Okay, guys. This is where we're at now. No, it looks like I have a lot of foundation on. I know it does, and it's because I do. It's because I do have a lot of foundation on, and we're gonna put more stuff on top of my face right now, which is gonna be fun. We need concealer. This is pretty basic. This is pretty much what, like, everybody does. Just put on your concealer how you would normally put on your concealer. I'm using Tarte Shape Tape in the color Fair Light Neutral. Make sure to regularly clean your sponge. Apparently, I'm on live television. Make sure to regularly clean your sponge. You know what works really well? Dish soap. It literally works so well. Because if you think about it, it breaks down oils, obviously, when you're cleaning your dishes. And, like, if you use the one that's, like, safe that they use on, like, little animals, you're chilling. Now you're like, Corey, this is just, like, regular makeup. What are you doing? Obviously, you're not teaching us anything. Okay. Next, what I found is also very convenient for me, at least, because my acne is mostly in my cheek area. So if I wanna, you know, obviously I wanna contour, obviously I wanna contour my face, but if I were to set my face right now and then go in with a bunch of powder products, I could be lifting a lot of the stuff that's already on my face. So that's why I like to go in with a cream contour, but not any type of cream contour. I want cream contour with lots of pigment. So instead of using just a cream contour stick, I use a cream foundation stick, which gives me more coverage and doesn't take away any of the coverage that I already have. Y'all see where I'm going with this? This one is way too dark for me, though, so I'm gonna scare you guys on accident. Just beware. It's gonna look a little fucking crazy for a second. I got it on clearance at Ulta. It was the lightest shade that they had, and I wanted to get it, okay? I will find one that's my shade, but I'm gonna freak you out a little bit. I'm with a really light hand right now, okay? So just, like, don't freak out. Also, this is how I contour my face now, because it's round, and I learned that I'm supposed to do that. But yeah. Foundation stick as cream contour really, really makes a difference, because it's not taking away any coverage. It's giving you more coverage, bitch. Pouncing your freaking product in for so long makes your hand really tired, but it's worth it. But yeah, anyways. Okay, and now here's another part that comes into play that helps cover my acne. Okay, so Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder, these have pigment to it. These aren't translucent. These have color to them, which gives you more coverage, which we want. And this is just a good ass powder anyways. Like, this powder is so freaking good, and I talk about it in all of my fucking videos. I use this all the fucking time. Like, I literally don't use any powder but this. But you know what, that just shows how freaking good it is. Maybelline, send me products. So I'm gonna use the lighter 05 underneath my eyes to brighten it up. And I'm gonna use this Real Techniques microfiber sponge. If you don't have this, you need to go get this. This fucking bakes your face beautifully. I will never use anything else ever again. Ever again. Okay? I don't know what the freak magic is in it, but it has some type of magic in it. Anyways, I take it on my little sponge. A lot. We have so much cream on our face right now. We need to set it. We need to really set it in there. All right. So under the eyes, using light one. The areas I want bright, nice and bright. Okay, and then the outer perimeters of my face, I'm gonna take the darker one. It's just like a one shade darker, and I'm gonna fully bake my whole face. My whole face. I bake the whole thing. And obviously, pimples are bumps. They're raised up, right? They're not flat. That'd be great if they were flat, you know? That'd be great if they were flat. But they come up from the skin, you know? So that's inevitable. But I have another trick. Right, we're looking extremely matte here, right? You're probably like, ew, you look so matte. Setting spray, bitch. I'm wearing pajamas right now, by the way. Aren't they cute? It's like a little set. Fashion Nova. Yeah, yeah. We're just like one color. Okay, so I use the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. Love this bitch. Literally love this bitch forever, you guys know that. But another technique that I like to use is I don't like to go like this. If I go like this on my face, I'm gonna lift up product and then you're gonna be able to see the pimples, okay? So I like to take the powder and dab it on. This is another technique. I like to take the bronzer and dab it. Because if you start swiping, swipe or no swiping, bitch. Mm-mm. You don't want to swipe. Dab it on there. And I'm a child. If the pimples do end up showing, just turn them into moles. Someone told me that I need to stop calling them moles and call them beauty marks. So, my beauty marks. This is one thing that I do swipe with too, because I don't have any pimples on my nose, so it doesn't bother me. But yeah, I just, even though I already cream contoured my nose, I like to powder contour it as well. Okay, and you guys know Milani Baked Luminoso is like my favorite highlighter of all time, or favorite blush of all time. But when I have a lot of acne on my cheeks, I don't like to use it because it has shimmer in it. And I don't want to bring out my my pimples anymore. I don't want to like make them shine, you know? Like that's not what I'm trying to do. So I'm taking the KBD blush, Everlasting blush in Foxglove. And we're going to put it on my cheeks. And keep it back here nice and cute. Dab. Dab it. Don't rub it, dab it. I still do use highlighter, yes I do, okay, but I don't use a lot. Take the e.l.f. My lips are so chapped. The e.l.f. Moonlight Pearls Highlighter, I can never get it open. All right, I really can't open this. Maybe if I use my jewel. Oh, there we go, that worked. And I only keep my highlighter right here. Okay, just right there. And then I like slowly, like that's where I want it to be the most pigmented, and I slowly blend it to the rest of my cheeks. And I know you guys are probably like, Cori, that's really fucking intense and that looks fucking crazy, but just give me a second. See, there's a pimple I have right there and I just highlighted it, which is kind of making me upset, but we're gonna turn it into a mole. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go put on eyelashes too, might as well. Okay, I don't know if this lighting is better. Can y'all see me? I feel like I should have had the camera here the whole fucking video, but I didn't. Anyways, I did my lips off of camera and my eyes because that doesn't matter. That's not part of this video. Okay, let's get on with the face. Okay, so we're gonna take MAC Fix Plus and spray this, a shit ton of this. We have so much product on our face right now. We need to put a shit ton of this on our face, right? Okay, and then when it's like semi-dry, I take my beauty blender, not the fucking smoke, and I pat everything in, which makes the highlighter not only look a lot less intense, but it makes everything just blend together nice and pretty. And then this is the last trick that I do. I take this brow pen from Anastasia. You could honestly use anything. You could use like a pomade. You could use anything. I used to use a pomade and like an angled brush. You could do anything, use anything to make these little fake moles. But pretty much, you see I have this pimple right here. This really big one. Mole. Just fuck it. You turn it into a mole. Another one right here. You turn it into a mole. Right? I have a huge one up here, turn it into a mole. Cute, moles are cute. Beauty marks, moles, whatever you wanna call them. But like I have so many on this side of my face now, I wanna like even it out. I have a pimple right here. Mole. But now I have like, I feel like I need one right here. So even though I don't have a pimple over here, I'm gonna put one over here. Gorge. Would you look at that? This is how I cover my pimples with freaking makeup. With having a ring light on in front of me, what? I'm like trying to make myself look cuter and it's not working.
but I will bring you guys outside so you guys can see what this looks like in natural daylight and not a freaking ring light, because that is not real life. Here is my skin in the natural daylight. There's literally a car right there, and it's the bitch that I don't fucking like that I yelled at yesterday. We're not gonna talk about it. She told me I couldn't park my car in front of my house. Where am I supposed to park it then? Anyways, this is what my skin looks like in the natural lighting of the sun. That's really fucking hot. Jesus, it's really hot today. But yes, this is my skin in natural light, and this is what it looks like all done. I'm going back inside because it's really fucking hot out here. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative. I hope that it helped you. Yeah, I just hope that it helped. This is how I cover my pimples with makeup. If you have pimples, know that I know how you feel, and don't be insecure because you're still a bad bitch. Having pimples doesn't make you not a bad bitch because you're still a bad bitch. You know? So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this was informative. I'm going to leave every product that I used down below in the order that I used it just to help you guys out. But, yeah, I love you guys so freaking much. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you're having a great day wherever you are. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Be good to your brain. Be good to your brain. Be good to your motherfucking brain. Bitch. I love you. Goodbye.